Today, we will look at automation, in particular volume automation, but I will show how you can also automate other parameters in your DAW for audio tracks, but you can do similar things for MIDI tracks. Okay, so we have our project again. Here it is. Let's play it again. There it is. And so one thing that we can do is to do volume automation. Now, and to do this for an audio track, here the vocals, we need to hover over the track. And then you see this small rectangle arrow appearing, show height automation. And if you click on this, the track will expand and you already will see volume. So if you click on to open this menu, then you see that there are many more parameters that you can select for automation, and there are more. I will come back to that. And you can also remove your automation from this menu. But let's start with the volume automation. So now what we want to do is to make the volume changing over time. So now it is set at a specific level, so 0 dB, and that is constant for the complete track. But now let's suppose that for this part of the vocals we want to decrease the vocals a bit. So now what we can do is to click on this thin line that you see here. So I click it and I do a second click, because now from this point on I can say, well, I want to decrease the volume. And then after this part of the vocal, I again click two times and now I can increase it again. So now we have automated, as it is called, the volume. So if you now play the clip, you will see that the volume goes down in this part, and you will also be able to see that on the fader. And we now see that the R from read automation is enabled, so it is green. So we can also turn it off, then it will not use the volume automation, so then it will just stay at a constant volume level. But now, because we have added volume information to the track, we can enable this, and now we are going to play it again. So there it is. So you see that now the volume has dropped in level. Now, there are different ways for doing automation in this lane, for defining the automation. So we now did it by clicking these edit points and then just with the mouse move them to any position where we want them to be. So for example, we can also do a small crescendo from here, let's say like this. So whatever you want to have. But there are other possibilities. So you can also select the draw, the pencil tool here. And if you do that, then you can just draw in the automation that you would like to see. So that's another way of doing it. And finally, we have this button here, in which you can select different shapes, like line, for example. Then you can just draw in a line, and then that will be your volume automation, or you can do a sine, for example. So now if you just hold the mouse, you can put in a sine, and by using the control key on your keyboard, you can also change the width of the intervals. So this is then how you can do automation by using your mouse. There's one other possibility. So let's remove the volume automation, So I say remove volume automation. So now it's back at this this level. And we can also use the fader to write volume automation. So then we enable the write mode. So then it will actually record volume information. And now you can just move the fader around. I will do that. So I will go to the start of my track. I will hit play. And then I will move the fader. Let's go. So you see that I have now written the volume automation just by moving the fader. So now I'm done with recording the automation and I can just disable the write mode. So that is how you do this. Now one thing that you need to know that once you have written automation, you can no longer set the fader to a different position. So you see it automatically snaps back because it is, you have set the volume level through the automation. So you cannot change the volume anymore by the fader. If you disable the read mode, then of course you can. But at the moment that you activate it again, then it will snap back. Now, so if you want to make adjustments, there are multiple ways of doing so. For example, you can select this part. And then with the mouse, you can, for example, increase or decrease the volume changes that you made. Or if you do it in a corner, you can tile the volume changes that you made. So there are all kinds of possibilities to make the changes afterwards. There are even more possibilities to do that. And there is also a menu for the automation. So you can open the automation panel. Then you will get this menu and there are other possibilities to do automation. And also in this menu there are different types of automation which I will not go into. Okay, so now we have volume automation. We can also do, let's remove this. Now let's leave it in. We can add or automate a second parameter. And so we need a second automation lane, second automation track. So we can now click on this plus symbol. So if you hover the mouse over this automation lane of the volume, we get a plus. And you can continue that. So you can add as many parameters as you want. But let's first now do the panner. So then we select the standard panner. So that is for panning the audio to the left or right channel. And now let's just have it moving from left to the center. From left to right and back. So I can just let me make 3 points. So now it is all the way to the left. Then here at the bottom, I will move this to the bottom. Then at this stage, it will be all the way to the right. And so you can also see that here in the fader. Eh? So now I'm this position is completely to the right, while here I'm completely to the left. And now I can move it back again all the way to the left. So now we can play again and watch the panner going and watch the fader going. There we go. Okay, let's add another automation lane. And in this time we are going to automate the equalizer. So now we need to select more. And the equalizer is in the strip. And let's suppose that we want to do the second band of the standaard Cubase equalizer and we want to change the frequency. So we select it. So now we have it here. We can now automate the frequency. And let's just draw in a sign. Sorry, I have to select this. And let's see if I can draw a sign here. So there it is. It's not the best one, but you will get the picture. So now let's open edit channel settings here. And then you will see what will happen with the automation. So now here the second band is enabled from our equalizer. Here it is. You see here our panner. Here we have the volume fader. Now I'm going to play again. And then you will see that the volume, the panner, but also the frequency is automated from the equalizer. Let's try to do this. Okay, now, so now the frequency changes are going so fast, so it doesn't make much sense. You can also not really hear this, but it is just to demonstrate that you can automate the equalizer, but you can also automate plugins. Now, let's suppose that we are going to add, let's say, a reverb. Let's take the room. Works from Steinberg. So here it is. And in principle, you can automate any of these knobs. So let's see if we can now automate the reverb time. So what we will do, we add another automation lane. We open the menu. We go to more. Now we see that there is also the insert. Here, because we have added a plugin, and now we have all the parameters of the of this reverb. So now we should find the amount of reverb. Let's see if we can find this. So it is reverb time. So it's probably this one. So we select this. Okay. So now we can also automate the amount of reverb time. Let's see if that is going to work. I will just increase it from at this moment almost, let's say, 0 seconds to the end to 4.5 seconds. So let's play. Now you hear that also the reverb is increasing. So that is one thing that you can do. And so maybe you now say, okay, at this part of the vocals here, this only this part, I don't want to have any reverb at all. So then you can either set the level to 0 at this particular point. So you can, for example, say, well, at this point, until here, perhaps I don't want to have any reverb, so we set the reverb level to 0. So that is one way of doing it. But in principle, you can also bypass a plugin. So that is this button. So we could also say, well, let's add another automation lane. We now going to select insert again, the plugin, and then we have here, we have bypass. So we select this. And now we have bypass as an automation lane. And if you want to bypass it, then we just set it to bypass at this stage. So if you go here, then you see that it is bypassed. And at that moment, in this part, we then don't have any reverb. Now, we have seen that for reverb, you can also use effects channels. So then you won't have a reverb directly in your insert slot, but then you have a send here to an effects channel. But you can also, if you wish, automate the sends. So you can enable them, the amount of signal that you send to your effects track, etc. So you can in principle automate everything that you want. So now another thing, just to show quickly, so if you add a group track, you can also automate groups. So now we have a group, but now the volume is already here. So you don't have to open the track, but if you want to have more automation tracks, then you click on the rectangle, and then you can, in addition to volume, you can also select other parameters that you want to automate for complete groups. And this works similarly for the effects channels. And also for MIDI channels, as you see, you can automate different parameters. So that works the same. So this helps you in doing the mixes, but it can also allows you to add some creative aspects by playing around, for example, with the panner or with the equalizer or doing other fun stuff. Okay.